We've got one final challenge here at New Mexico Tech. It's time to see if Tommy and I can put together all we've learned about blast waves.
You've learned a lot with all this blast wave work. Now you're going to put that knowledge to use. Or you fail the test and we kick you out of school.
Oh, great. No pressure.
Here's how this final challenge is going to work. We've got two walls. Tommy's is made out of brick, and my wall is made out of cinder block. Mike and John are going to try to knock them down with 200 pounds of ammo. Tommy and I have to try and stop them using only these buckets. Tommy's are full of water. Mine are filled with sand.
This is going to be a good test of what you've learned.
So the question is, where do we place these protective materials?
Right.
Are we going like against our wall, in the middle, or right against the explosives?
Yeah. We're also going to go back to our tried and true dummies and see if they can survive the blast waves from inside the room.
Good luck.
Whatever.
I was talking to my dummy.
We've learned our lesson from the other blasts. Both of us place our dummies as far away from the blast as possible in the back corner of the room. Tommy's up first.
I just had a good idea.
Yeah?
Okay. Yeah. I feel like the water is going to be a factor in like destroying the wall. So I'm going to make it as safe as possible by putting it as far over there as possible and high so it's not wide.
Okay. Get stacking.
All right.
All right.
I feel like that's my best bet.
So sometimes when water is hit with a really strong explosive force, it essentially becomes a projectile and inflicts even more damage than a blast would on its own. So Tommy might be onto something here. Maybe.
Well, it's just on a little bit of an angle.
But, you know.
Look out for the other.
Probably not.
I didn't do that.
After a quick cleanup on aisle 7, it's time to see if his strategy works. Let's head back to the bunker and blow this popsicle stand.
Okay, charging.
Do you want to say anything before you say goodbye to your wall?
Any last words, Tommy?
Go yourself.
Okay, here we go. In 3, 2, 1.
What the hell? That was huge. I don't think anything would have stopped that wall from getting destroyed. All right, let's go see if you survived.
Ah!
Whoa! Oh, dude, your dummy is gone.
I knew it was gonna be bad. I didn't know it was gonna be that bad.
Any sign of him yet?
Nope. It didn't even slow it down. John huffed and puffed and blew my wall down. Rotten.
Hey, there he is.
You want to check the sensors, see if he survived?
You want to catch a fast brick?
It's going to survive.
The fact that the sensor is destroyed pretty much tells us everything we need to know.
I'm going to go work on mine. Good luck saving your dummy. I don't even think there's a way to save these walls after seeing how big these 200-pound explosions are. I mean, I think he would have been better off doing something with those buckets, but now it's my turn. My strategy is I'm just gonna load up a bunch of the buckets of sand right next to the blast, pile everything up on top of my ampho, so that way when it goes off, this absorbs all that energy and then it doesn't reach my wall. I'm just wondering, like, what the best way to stack these? Do I just do like a double wall? I mean, most of the shockwave is gonna be low. Or do I have, is that it? That's all the buckets I have? Like some further back so that, I don't know. Is that really gonna do anything? All right, there.
Oh, I think that one bucket on top is just gonna do it for you. Is that bucket there for balance?
See? This is what I gotta deal with.
Forget it. I'm just gonna go with my gut. Let's head to the bunker and see what happens.
Okay, is everybody ready?
Ready.
Here we go in 3, 2, 1.
There's no way.
Yours looked like it was bigger.
There's no way that wall survived.
I get the feeling that no matter how I stack my buckets, that wall was doomed. Just look at the way the blast reaches all the way over to Tommy's room and knocks debris off the roof. And I'm pretty sure those are some of my bricks flying through the air.
There's no way. I can't even see. There's a big cloud of dust.
But as long as I have one tiny cinder block standing, I'll have done better than Tommy.
So your scheme, even though the wall fell down, it worked pretty good. There's just a slight amount of debris on the back wall, and your mannequin.
Look, I put him in the right spot.
You put him in the exact right location.
So just like the walls at the Urban Canyon and the bigger wall in the car bomb, my buckets of sand essentially created a small blast shadow, which deflected some of the damage. This same principle has been used to design military bases for decades.
The fact that you actually put your mitigation scheme between the wall and the charge made all the difference. Tommy's, if he would have put it next to the charge but not in contact with the charge, it might have worked to help mitigate the blast.
I may have gotten beaten today, but the best part about explosions is, I mean, hey, we all win because we got to watch an explosion. I did suck though.
Well, it has been a very informative day here at New Mexico Tech.
You guys are awesome.
Yeah.
A great job.
Well, we've enjoyed having you guys here and we hope to see you again soon.
We sacrificed a lot of dummies to learn one thing. Best place to be in an explosion is as far away as possible. Not that we're gonna actually heed that advice.
What else can we blow up, Tommy?